Bharadwaj and I belong to the Mathura region of North India. I have studied Shukla Yajurveda, Madhyandina Shaka, and the Shraut and Grihya Karma related to it, and some Vedangas also. And I studied my Shukla Yajurveda in Dudeshwaranath Veda Parshala in Ghaziabad, near Delhi. And then I went to Pune. In Alandi, I learned some portions of Shatapatha Brahmana from Sri Vishwanath Joshi Guruji. And I learned my Shraut and Grihya Karmas from Sri Venkatesha Vadhani in Mathur. My Upanayanam was done in Mathur, only in Shimoga district in Karnataka. So basically, I'm trying to do my bit for the cause of the...
Before that, you basically are coming from, you were working in an IT company.
Okay.
So now you have completely resigned and you are doing full time in this. Yes. Regarding that, please.
Actually, you can say that there is no particular incident or something which motivated me in this direction, but it's the gradual samskara of my family, you could say. My father is in modern profession, he is also in IT only. My grandfather was a farmer in Mathura district. So, but like any other general Brahmin family, we are deeply dharmic. So somehow that samskara got too strong in me, and I thought I should do whatever I can do to for the cause of the dharma revival, because whatever we see around ourselves in the common society these days, it's quite disheartening. Not only that, people are unaffected by whatever is happening to the causes of dharma, they are actually contributing to the degradation and downfall of the dharmic portions of the dharmic culture of our society. So that is quite disheartening, and I thought at least I should do something, whatever I can do. I may not be able to change the whole thing or whatever, but I should make an attempt at getting things right and withholding our traditions and reviving whatever our ancestor rishis had ordained on us to do it in whatever manner they told us to do. So that is one thing, and so motivated by that, I thought that I need to give all my time for this cause. So last year on 31st March, that was my last working day. I was working in Wipro, and before that BillHCL. I worked in IT for 5 years, and even during that time I was doing whatever I could do for the cause of dharma. Since last year, March last year, April last year, I am doing this 24 hours, so I am fully devoted to this cause of dharma. So we are running a few projects, for example this manuscript digitization project. So the Academy of Sanskrit Research Melukote, there we have our manuscript digitization center. We are taking photos and scanning and taking pictures of the manuscripts present there, so that they are it is ensured that they are not lost due to neglect or carelessness or whatever reasons. So this is what we have done in Baswada also. Baswada is a place in Rajasthan. So there is this Shankhan Shakha of Rig Veda. There are only two Samhita parties of this Shakha, Shri Indushankar Jha Guruji and Shri Harshad Nagar Guruji. They live in Nagarwada in Baswada. So they are quite aged people. They are around 80 years of age. So around 4.5 years ago, we arranged for our friend Shri Abhijit Dinkar Savade, who is from Trembakeshwar, Nasik. So he had already studied his Shukla Yajurveda, Madhyandina Shakha until Krama Patha. He's basically a Rigvedi, but because there was no Rigveda Parshala nearby, so he studied Shukla Yajurveda. And then we arranged for him to go there, to go these two acharyas and learn the Shankhana Samhita. Meanwhile, we ensured that his financial aspect of his family, because he is the only earning member of his family, so that is unaffected. So he has studied his Shakha in last, he has studied this Shankhana Shakha. And in June this year, June 23rd to June 30th, we organized the Shankhana Rigveda Parayana in Baswada under the guidance of these two acharyas only. So Abhijit has learned his Samhita. That is one project we have been doing. And all the manuscripts these people have, one of which is Rigveda from 1468 AD, which is the second oldest paper manuscript of Rigveda. The first one is 1464 AD in Bhandarkar in Pune. This is the second one which these people had. So we have digitized around 45,000 images from these people, and they include rare Shraudha Granthas and Granthas related to Samaveda Gurjara Paddhati of the Gautama Shakha. So that is what work we have done in Baswara. Planning ahead, we are, there are some people in Kerala, Namputiri people, who are well versed in Shankhya, Shraut and Grihya Sutras. They don't have the Samhita like these Baswara people, but they do have the Grihya and Shraut Sutra, which the Baswara people are not very good at. So we have arranged for Abhijit to go there and go to Kerala and study the Shaka. So for that also we are seeking financial assistance. More importantly, we are trying to revive the Shrauta culture, the Shrauta tradition in North India. It is practically vanquished from North India for centuries now, probably. The few Agnihotris who are there, they are basically from South India only, in Varanasi. The Shukla Yajurveda tradition is lost, practically lost, I mean. There is one Acharya, Shri Madhav Rao Agnihotri, but he is in Maharashtra. So in this region flooded by Ganga, Yamuna, Saraswati, so there is no one. We are trying to revive that, and we are trying to set up a Veda Pathshala in Mathura or Kurukshetra. So where it should be, where the, I say this, that Veda is not a matter of, it's not a subject of study, it's a subject of living. You have to be actually practicing it. So we intend to set up such a Pathshala where the Brahmacharis are actually studying all the six Vedangas and actually living the tradition, not just reciting the Samhita or just learning the Paurohitya, not limited to that, but way more than that. So that is what we are attempting for, and we are seeking resources for that as well. So this is all about me. Thank you. Namaste.